Okay.
So it's the grand final. Welcome to the grand final of Tetris Tournament Online 4. Sorry about the delay. My net was literally dying. my net literally bugged out. That's why I reset the stream, because the TF's website was just sending me 404, and I was like, what? But the stream was okay. It was really funny. Sorry for that.
Yeah, but we're back now. Yeah, so both these players starting out at blazing fast speeds. We can kind of see why both these players are already here at the finals of this tournament. So once again, fighting for the title of the best Tetris player in the world. Both these players are going at it from the start.
Wait.
So Yui Metal getting pushed all the way up to the top already, but it looks like he'll be able to make his way down. I2 with a very nice stack, squeezing in a T-spin double there while having a small combo down to his Tetris toll. He manages to keep the back-to-back really well, the T-spin double followed by a back-to-back Tetris. Yui Metal doesn't look like he's in too much trouble, though. He is going to down stack and setting up T-spin double into a Tetris. I2 going to set up a T-spin double. Pretty creative way to do that. And instead of a T-spin double, he actually creates a T-spin single in order to make his Tetris stack a little bit cleaner than taking just the basic line of the T-spin double.
Now you meta with cleaning everything. He wanna send a Tetris and Jaitsuka. Oh, getting the garbage, but getting a nice... Oh, that's a misdrop. That's a misdrop, but a really quick to fix misdrop actually. And we begin with the hurry up garbage. I2K.
Yeah, so the hurry up garbage is coming up now. Once again, this is the first to 15, and you need to win by two. So the format will still be the same as it is throughout the tournament. And both these players really fighting as a hurry up garbage, trying to just keep their stack very clean, but I2 makes a misdrop. Yui Metal, he doesn't look like he's able to capitalize on it, but he keeps his stack very clean while sending very potent T-spin doubles. I2 wasn't able to time that Tetris.
Oh, it's going to be the first round for Yui! It is!
And he will be giving the first game away to Yui Metal.
Yui Metal!
205 lines sent from Yui Metal.
Wow, man.
95 from I2 in just a little bit over 2 minutes and a half.
Wow, that was a really fast first round. Honestly, it was not fast, but it was a lot of attack.
Goodness. So I2K manages to make it through the finals after, from what I remember, playing a very, very dodgy first game. So the very first match of his tournament versus Bento Boxer. And I think he kind of underestimated Bento Boxer, or Bento Boxer almost eliminated I2 from the tournament completely. But now he's here facing Yui Metal, and Yui Metal... You know, he's not as famous as I2 is, but he is going to be making a name for himself here today. I2, really nice stacking. A little bit of a misdrop there, but he will make his way down to Cetrisol. A lot of really, really nice stacking coming from I2 in these games. Yui Metal, it looks like he's pausing a little bit. It looks like he tried to time his Tetris to be more aggressive to send garbage to I2 instead of trying to cancel out garbage. And so I2 once again being pushed to the top, but his stack has been kept so clean that no matter how much garbage a Yui Metal manages to send to him, it looks like he's still in a very good spot. Yui Metal a little bit of problematic garbage, but he manages to stack down. Just a small T-spin double into a combo manages to top out I2. And Yui Metal takes a second game. There's a lot of momentum going for Yui Metal from the start. And I2, once again, having a slow start. I think this is maybe part of I2's game plan where, you know, he's taking a few games to kind of feel out his opponent. And in the past, we've seen him, you know, lose multiple games in the beginning and then kind of come back. So maybe trying to find the rhythm that Yui Metal plays at and trying to really create a game plan around the strengths of Yui Metal, which seems to be currently his burst damage. Okay, so Aitsu, once again, being pushed to the top, but Yui Metal's hanging on. You know, when you're at this level of Tetris, basically, no matter how fast you are, you need to really try to catch your opponent at a kind of an interval where they're not really, where I guess they're in between stacking and in between sending garbage. Because otherwise, you're not really going to be able to get anywhere with just blindly sending garbage. Okay, so but once again, both these players just not really doing too much right now. Aitsu looks like he might be in a position soon to send a lot of burst damage over to Yui Metal, but Aitsu is trying to just keep it low. Yui Metal has some pretty clean garbage to work through, and once again, you can see Yui Metal pausing in between his piece drops, just because I guess he's just trying to, once again, just to time his garbage so that he can be more aggressive versus Aitsu. I'm not sure if that's going to be the best strategy versus Aitsu, but wow, with that miss drop, that is going to be it. Once again, Yui Metal is going to see the third game. So much momentum on Yui Metal's side. Yeah, so three games in a row. What? Oh my goodness. Okay, so Aitsu manages to cancel out his garbage, but once again, these miss drops are really putting kind of a kink into Aitsu's rhythm. Here, Yui Metal, his stacking isn't as nice as Aitsu's, but, you know, he's just playing a very solid game. I'm quite surprised kind of from Yui Metal's kind of game plan. Wow, perfect clear. So Yui Metal actually tried to go for a second perfect clear after that. But as I was saying, Yui Metal, his style doesn't look to be too flashy. So I guess it just comes down to just very strong, basic gameplay that brought Yui Metal here to the finals of Tetris Tournament 4. Okay, so once again, both these players kind of dancing around. There's about 20 seconds left until Hurry Up Garbage comes up. So basically going into Hurry Up Garbage, you really want to keep your stack as clean as possible. And going into Hurry Up Garbage, you can really capitalize on just the basic skill sets that you've learned in Tetris, where, you know, just good stacking, very efficient attacking will basically allow you to top out your opponents. But when it comes to this high level of players, I'm not sure if that's going to be that simple. So Aitsu, once again, pushing to the top, he's making a small combo all the way down, but all that garbage is unfortunately just going to be canceling Yui Metal's garbage. So Aitsu, a very, very aggressive, attack there, but this miss drop, he's going to have to be able to clear through this miss drop in order to get down to his Tetris hole. And wow, Yui Metal didn't manage to actually top out Aitsu, and just one line off from a perfect clear, Yui Metal almost managed to steal a game there. Aitu, he's not managing to be too aggressive. He's sending just a few doubles here and there. But Yui Metal, he's basically pushed to the top. He manages to send a Tetris, but he tops out just before Aitu does. So Aitu is going to take his first game. It will be 3-1 to Yui Metal. But so once again, this might be kind of the point where Aitu is getting a feel for Yui Metal's playing. And I wouldn't be surprised to see kind of the tides turning now. Okay. So already off to blazing fast start, and wow, so both these players are just basically playing and trying to find some sort of opening in their opponent's play. So whether it's some sort of misdrop that they can capitalize on, or maybe they find like a lucky Tetris hole and they manage to combo down and send a huge spike of garbage like Yui Metal does now. Yui Metal is going to take the fifth game. So it will be 4-1. Yui Metal over Aitu. So as I said before, this will be the 1st to 15. But both these players... Yeah, I can hear you now. Welcome back,
Gazer. Okay, I'm back. Oh, sorry. It was really funny.
Okay. Yeah, so it is 4-1. Yui Metal over Aitu right now. So Aitu starting with a Tetris opening. It's actually an opening, even though this game's called Tetris, it's an opening that we don't see quite often. So Aitu, already with a flashy start, he follows up with some pretty good back-to-back Tetris. But Yui Metal, it looks like he's just sending some messy downset garbage.
Hey, now we see Yui Metal with he's gonna send a Tetris. No, he's sending a back-to-back Tetris with a back-to-back T-spin double. No, it was just a back-to-back Tetris and a back-to-back spin double. Aitu getting really high in the playfield right now. He needs to clean that. He needs to clean that out. He needs an IPC. He got it. He got a Tetris, and Aitu is back into the game.
Yeah, so Aitu managed to cancel out the garbage that Yui Metal sent over to him quite nicely. I think Yui Metal, if he was watching a bit more carefully, he could have capitalized on that small chance. If he just waited a little bit, I think he could have topped out Aitu there. But Yui Metal just focusing on his own game, trying to just stay in his rhythm. But I think that Aitu is a player who can kind of feel out players' rhythms. And as I said before, I wouldn't be too surprised if Aitu just gets stronger as a match proceeds, just because he's really good at just kind of understanding how players tend to attack, and in the past that's kind of been a strong suit.
Oh, you made it gonna send a Tetris, and Aitu is sending a T-spin double. He actually missed the opportunity for a Tetris, but he's gonna fix it now with another T-spin double. You made that with a 4-wide.
Oh my goodness! And oh. A lucky Tetris hole.
He got a Tetris, he missed the 4-wide. He missed the 4-wide. But it was enough to send an attack.
I think Yui Metal messed up on that. He could use the J piece in order to continue the 4-wide, but he is trying to go at it right now. But it's not going to be good enough. They will be going into hurry up garbage. Yui Metal trying to be very aggressive here. He sees Aizu's at the top.
Oh, he's okay with a miss drop.
Wow. The thing is that both these players seem to be so close in skill. However, Aitu is making a lot of misdrops compared to Yui Metal, who I don't think I've actually seen him misdrop a single time in this series yet.
Actually not. Not a single misdrop by Yui Metal. Oh, look, the same setup. Aitu got the perfect clear. Yui Metal did a counter perfect clear.
Yeah, and so both of those neutralize each other out.
Now, bot player with wow.
My god, so Yui Metal got topped out by Aitu. Barely within just one line. So he topped out by just one line. So maybe that was kind of a like a miscalculation on Yui Metal's part, but Aitsu managed to sneak through.
Course, the information of Aitsu before the match, his sprint time was 29.53 seconds. His last match against was Evo Mai, the current world champion, was a win. That's information about Aitsuke. Well, we see Yui Metal doing another four wipe.
Wow.
Oh, so man.
This is actually a good Tetris hole. So, okay, he doesn't manage to capitalize on it, but he needs to make it down to the
Tetris hole.
Yeah, he manages to get it.
He managed to get through
and
the
Yui Metal. This is the problem when you send a strong opponent so much garbage is that you're just going to get all sent right back. And Aitsu with that missed drop, that is going to be another loss here for Aitsu. I think Aitsu needs to probably slow down a little bit just because those missed drops are basically just losing him games immediately to Yui Metal. He can't really afford to miss drop even a single time against this strong opponent.
It's now 6-2, right?
I think so.
Oh, it's accurate, right? Yes, it is. It's accurate, yes. But I fix it.
Okay, so Yui Metal. Once again, like, Yui Metal's start is pretty strange to me. Like, oftentimes, Yui Metal seems just to be capitalizing basically on the momentum of Aitsu. Yui Metal just trying to get down to that garbage. He's playing a lot safer than Aitsu has been. But then the thing is, he throws in, like, you know, some random things. Like, in the middle of the game, he'll just stack for a combo. And once again, he's doing that here. So, kind of a wannabe four-wide combo here. But I don't think he'll be able to get out of this one. That was just way too much garbage.
No, it's point for Aitsu. Absolutely.
Yeah. Absolutely. Oh, my gosh. Aitsu is really, really good at spiking. So, it is a liability just to be too aggressive, right? Like, you send your opponent so much clean garbage that basically you just have to expect it all to come back. And if the opponent can connect it with a combo, then you should expect to get just spiked out of the game. Okay. T-spin openings for both players. Once again, Aitsu with a better stack. Yui Metal just trying to get down, trying to survive. Pretty awkward stacking for Yui Metal. Wow, he manages to find two eye pieces in a row. And that is going to save him for now. Aitsu with pretty nice down stack combo. He decides to cancel all out instead of try to absorb garbage, send it back. Yeah, both these players basically not making any headway at all. Just stacking and once again trying to find some sort of opportunity. Yui Metal has been trying to make his own opportunities by basically, you know, stacking up a Tetris, or sorry, stacking up like a combo setup right in the middle of the game, which is pretty unorthodox. You know, you need to be really, really fast, and you need to have basically the courage to be able to do so, because against a player like Aitsu, you know, he can see you stacking up that, the combo setup. Yeah, so just basic Tetris stacking there from Aitsu, squeezing in a few creative T-spin doubles. Okay, about 15 seconds until hurry-up garbage. So hurry-up garbage is basically this game's form of fatigue. So without the hurry-up garbage, I guess oftentimes these games would just go on for, you know, for maybe like 10 minutes if neither player is very aggressive. But the hurry-up garbage really forces these players to play a different type of game, basically a sudden death match where you really need to show that you're really, really good at Tetris in order to consistently pull off this late game. So Aitsu with really, really nice down stack, but Yui Metal being very aggressive. Just look at these very consistent T-spin setups.
Yui Metal is getting a spike. Oh, he got the eye piece.
But look, he managed that.
Oh my god.
Aitsu managed to cancel it out. Oh no, Aitsu!
Aitsu, no!
Eye piece missed drop. Aitsu gets his eye piece stuck vertically. And I think That wasn't even a misrotation. I think that's actually the way that the kicks work, right? So the thing is, he tried to...
But we see, well, wait, the information of Yui Metal is 27.60 seconds, and his last match was against Hiro Mai. He won also on the loser bracket match, and he actually lose to Aitsuke on the winner's bracket, 11-15 on the second round. So Yui Metal is now making the loser's bracket comeback against a player that actually eliminating him from the winner's bracket.
So does it mean that he needs to win twice then?
Exactly. Yui Metal needs to win twice. Yui Metal is from loser bracket. But Aitsuke eliminated Yui Metal on the second round of the winner's bracket. And now Yui Metal is making it.
So if Aitsu wins this, then he will get a second chance, right?
Exactly. If Aitsu wins, it's over. But if Yui Metal wins...
Yeah, if Aitsu wins, it's win.
Exactly. But if Yui Metal wins, Aitsu gets another chance.
Okay. Wow, amazing. Like, Yui Metal, even though his style is... You know, maybe you can say it's kind of boring. But Yui Metal, he's squeezing, like, T-spin triples... Basically at light speed, and I guess it just kind of shows off how flexible Yui Metal is and the depth of his Tetris knowledge. Yeah, Yui Metal making a nice spin there, fixing his stack. Aitsu, once again, not being very aggressive. You know, oftentimes, even though you send, like, very fast T-spin doubles, the amount of time in between setting up those T-spin doubles, it gives your opponent a lot of breathing room. So oftentimes, the most aggressive play is not just constant pressure of T-spin doubles and Tetris, but a combination of various combos, Tetrises, and T-spin doubles in quick succession.
Actually, it's amazing that both of these players defeated Hiro Mai.
Yeah. Hey, so Hiro Mai, he won the first, second, and third Tetris tournament online. Basically, he was the god of the Tetris world.
Until this tournament. Whoa, and that's another
until
round.
Until this tournament, where we will be looking to crown a new god of the Tetris world. Yeah, and Aitsu...
gets another round. That's 7-4. Still 3 points behind Yui Metal. Yui Metal have 3 rounds of play, so... It's... This round is more amazing than that because Yui Metal is winning against, like, his worst enemy of this tournament. Remember, Aitsuke is the worst nightmare of Yui Metal. He defeated Yui Metal, and now he's defeating back.
Mm-hmm. But, whoa, you know, nice you defeat. Have to kind of think... Yeah, you kind of have to think that Yui Metal has maybe prepared somehow for this battle once again, you know? I can't expect that a player of this caliber to, you know, just willingly lose to the same player twice. So,
Yui Metal making some miss drops, but he's fixing it now. Aitsuke still have enough attack to send.
No,
Yui Metal, he doesn't.
Yeah, that's the thing, because oftentimes you try to top out your opponent when you see that they're, you know, really high up at the top. But what happens after that is that all of that burst damage you sent is actually very clean garbage. So once your opponent gets down to that, you basically lose all of your initiative. So,
oh man, that was a huge spike.
Yeah, Yui Metal manages to flip that game, and Yui Metal would take another game here. So Yui Metal far in the lead over Aitsu.
4 games. It's not that far.
Because, I mean, it's double, right? It's double.
It's still not that far until he will get like 5 or 6 points in a row. That's far. That's a lot. Still, 4 games is not enough, I think.
But the thing is that at this caliber of play, right? I think that having twice as many wins, it relieves a lot of pressure for me, right? The thing about Tetris is that when you're behind games, it really, really works against your, you know, against
four white,
basically
four
your,
white.
Your mentality. Yeah, so the four white here comes from Aitsu.
Here's come.
Let's see how
he's
far
gonna make it.
Wow,
the Metal
this
hit
shuts
the spike.
Him up out
oh, this will kill.
Middle.
This will kill. This will kill. There it is. There it is.
As we can see, Aichi now, the first time I think, pulls off what Yui Metal has been doing, which is like a mid-game combo setup. So yeah, we can see that the 4-wide combo is still one of the most potent tools in the game, one of the most potent weapons.
And the 4-wide actually was so fun to watch. Especially for a squad tournament, man, that was a really fun match.
Yeah, because sometimes, you know, the 4-wide combo, they can't connect it all the way, but Aichi managed to connect it the entire thing, and as got a full matrix of garbage sent to him.
Oh, Yui Meta's gonna send the spin double, he's gonna clean that. Aichi with a north spin double. Wow. Nice spin, Aichi is gonna clean that. Maybe, there it is. Yes, it's gonna be.
Yui Metal with an awesome attack, but Aichi managing to neuter that attack. Now it's kind of back to the same kind of game plan that, you know, both players are just trying to, you know, just kind of take it easy. But Yui Metal is quickly pushed to the top right as I say that. Aichi with a crazy, crazy setup here. Double T-spin double into a back-to-back Tetris. Manages to top out Yui Metal. Wow, this is basically a game of just two hard hitters basically, you know, spiking each other out. So Aichi closing this gap. As you said, I guess maybe four game difference isn't that much. So Aichi only has two more wins until he catches up to Yui Metal's 8. Double perfect clear setup by both players. Yui Metal gets it, but Aichi, look at this. He has so much. Oh my goodness, that miss drop. I think this miss drop.
Maybe he's in the game. No, he's fixing it. He got that. He missed that. Tetris.
Oh my god.
There it is.
So we can see there, by the way that Aichi got topped out, that the only pieces that he could use were either the eyepiece or something else that wasn't good. Maybe like a second O piece or something that was in his hold. So he didn't manage to clear his way down to cancel all the garbage, and Yui Metal takes a very cheeky win off of Aichi, widening the lead once again.
Oh, look, mirror setups. Almost mirror.
Okay, so both these players starting off with a Tetris start. Aichi, it's once again a bit of a miss drop, but not so bad. Okay, this miss drop might be a bit problematic, and that O-piece miss drop is going to lose him a lot of momentum. Yui Metal, though, has a few miss drops of his own. Pretty nasty garbage underneath Yui Metal's deck.
Oh, I took it. Needs to clean. He got that Tetris. So, he's gonna send them now.
Yeah, so Yui Metal not being too aggressive.
Man, he's focusing
on cleaning up
man,
his deck.
Man, that miss drop
is near the brink of topping out here. Aichi is trying to connect his way down, and he manages to clear a little bit, but is it going to be enough? He doesn't manage to get the eyepiece over. And Yui Metal is going to widen this gap even further. Okay, 10 wins versus Aichi's 9. Sorry, Aichi's 6. So once again, this 4-win gap. Yeah, so a lot of people there in the Twitch chat are hoping that Aichi loses his match just so that we can have another series. You know, all of the most interesting matches we've had in Tetris Tournament were maybe the Tetris Tournament 1, where, you know, Blink took Habomai into the second match, and we had a crazy action-packed day of Tetris action. So yeah, so Yui Metal having a really nice stack here. Aichi just trying to clean up his stack. He's sending T-spin doubles in between, but they're not seeming to do too much. Aichi with his miss drop here, I think this might be fatal. Yeah, he doesn't manage to find an eyepiece in order to clear down. And Yui Metal will be taking his 11th game. So I'm not sure exactly what Aichi needs to change. I think maybe part of that is just playing a little bit slower just to not really make those fatal misdrops, because Yuen Metal is very good at capitalizing the moment he sees Icy make a misdrop. Icy opening the perfect clear, Yuen Metal opening with some sort of weird double stacking combo opening. Yes, but Yuen Metal with a double Tetris, he is going to send some pretty clean garbage over to Icy. Yuen Metal setting up some C-spins here, but forfeiting his Tetris stack just a little bit. Icy trying to figure out a way to get to the bottom. It looks like he's offered some pretty awkward pieces in succession. Okay, Yuen Metal manages to send a T-spin double. But once again, these players are looking for an opening. Icy sends back another T-spin double. Yuen Metal, the T-spin triple. That's the second T-spin triple he's made in the series, followed by back-to-back T-spin double. Icy did get pushed to the top just a little bit, but the problem with the T-spin triple is that it sends so much clean garbage that that basically you're just loaning out the garbage, right? And then eventually your opponent's going to be pay it back. So Yuen Metal trying to figure out some way to be able to attack Icy here. I really liked his approach before where, you know, when he saw that he had like a really clean Tetris stack of garbage or like some very clean garbage coming up in the middle, he managed to stack up on the sides and to try to finish Icy out with some sort of combo spike. But it doesn't look like Yuen Metal's been able to find the opportunity yet. Icy just keeping with his very clean stacks with his somewhat passive T-spin doubles, but very efficient. About 5 more seconds until both these players go into hurry-up garbage. And I think that Yuen Metal, oh my gosh, that misdrop from Yuen Metal. Is he going to manage to make it down? No, he doesn't. So once again, another game goes to fatigue. Yuen Metal didn't manage to clean up his garbage in time to anticipate the fatigue garbage coming in. Icy managed to capitalize on that, but once again, he is 4 games behind. He is going to need quite a lot to close this gap, because at this rate, Yuen Metal is going to be taking this series. Okay, Yuen Metal with so much garbage. So much clean garbage from that perfect clear. Icy is not going to be able to send enough pressure to finish him off. But Icy now has opportunity to send a really, really big attack. Manages to connect the entire thing. So Icy is going to try to be aggressive right now. He sends a T-spin double, but it's not going to be enough. I think Icy at this point now, he's realizing that, you know, following up on very aggressive attacks with just like a T-spin double is not going to be enough to top out Yuen Metal. But Yuen Metal is going to be, he is going to be topped out anyways. Actually, really good at capitalizing on the opportunities given to him. So even though after that perfect clear, he didn't manage to top out Yuen Metal, he managed to just put on constant pressure that Yuen Metal eventually wasn't able to claw his way back into the game to find kind of a clear field where he could actually mount a counterattack. Okay, some misdrops here from Yuen Metal. I think Icy should be able to close this out here, because that garbage is really, really hard for Yuen Metal to clear through, and Icy takes 2 cheeky wins in a row. So closing the gap once again, Yuen Metal should be sweating right now. You know, that's the thing. Basically, no matter how much of an advantage you have, this is the finals of TTO4, so we should be expecting some insanely high quality play from both these players. Okay, Icy with a really nice field here. Yuen Metal gets somewhat of a lucky Tetris hole, but being pushed already to the top, I think Aitsu has kind of found Yui Metal's rhythm now. He's sending, so Aitsu, instead of sending just, you know, just some clean, just like some small consistent damage over time, he seems to be, you know, trying to stack up just a little bit higher just to connect his T-spins to his Tetrises and to his combos. And as we can see there, you know, he kind of ended that attack with a three combo. Yui Metal, he should be able to get out of this pretty easy down stack all the way down. Aitsu turning up the fire, putting on the pressure. Yui Metal's at the top, still sneaking in some T-spin doubles. But I see with a small misjump there, but it shouldn't be too bad. Both these players basically down at the bottom of the matrix right now. Okay, Aitsu with a little bit of misjump there on the Tetris, or sorry, on the T-spin double, but it doesn't seem to be too much of a problem. About 30 more seconds till these players go into hurry up garbage. So Yui Metal's garbage and his field has been pretty awkward. He hasn't been able to attack Aitsu at all this game. He's basically just defending. So we are going to go into hurry up garbage now. And I would have to say that both these players are actually quite even when it comes to this field. Before, both players simultaneously misdrop, but Aitsu's misdrop was way, way worse than Yui Metal's. And Yui Metal is going to be widening that gap once again. Just a few more games here for Yui Metal. And he will be taking it to a second first to 15 match. Okay, Aitsu looks like he's turning up the speed just a little bit. He's been playing a little bit faster now, but as we can see, maybe that resulted in that misdrop. So Aitsu managing to clear through his garbage very, very efficiently. Yui Metal with no real means of attack here. Yui Metal trying to stack up a little bit. I think I would like to see Yui Metal maybe try to stack up a little bit more like he did in the previous games, but maybe he thinks that that sort of strategy will no longer work versus Aitsu. Pretty big spike here coming from Aitsu, sending Yui Metal a lot of garbage. Aitsu making a creative T-spin double here while cleaning up his misdrop as well. So Yui Metal looks to be in a pretty good spot here. But a bit of a misdrop there with the eyepiece, I think. He is kind of in dangerous territory, but he managed to find a kind of a gap in I2K's attack where he managed to stack up a little bit, clear through his misdrops, and launch a small attack. But I2 is managing it really well. And once again, see just how good I2 is at managing his garbage. I think Aitsu's stacking might be one of the best stacking I've actually ever seen from any Tetris player. Yui Metal trying to claw his way down, but the way he's clearing his garbage is pretty awkward. It looks like Yui Metal manages to make it down. Aitsu now with kind of the awkward stack. Oh, Miss Sharper from Yui Metal! Yeah, so in order to make it out of that one, Yui Metal would have needed something like a Z piece into a J piece into a Tetris. So pretty unlikely, and I2K only two games behind now. So Yui Metal with 12 wins and Aitsu with 10. Okay, Aitsu starts once again with his favorite opening, which seems to be that perfect clear. T-spin doubles flying off the matrix by Aitsu. Yui Metal doesn't look to be as aggressive as he was in earlier games. He seems to be missed dropping quite a bit more as well. I'm not sure if Yui Metal can be able to make it through this. He manages to make it down to his garbage, but it looks like Aitu's attack right now is going to be sending a ton of garbage to Yui Metal, but Yui Metal manages to survive that attack by Aitu. So the tables have switched a little bit. Aitu is now the one with the really awkward garbage, and Yui Metal, while he is at the bottom, he isn't going to be able to send Aitu too much garbage. Aitu in the driver's seat, managing to make a few combo attacks consisting of Tetrises and T-spins. And once again, a small misdrop by Aitu. It is going to be cleaned up very, very well by, once again, another creative T-spin double. Yui Metal in a very, very nice spot here. And Yui Metal, once again, Yui Metal absorbed that garbage instead of canceling it. So I really like Yui Metal's approach here. I think that him being aggressive seems to be working out a lot better than the defensive strategy he was going for. And Aitu, Aitu looks like he's turning up his speed. He's playing way faster now too. Both these players cranking it up a gear. And hurry up garbage. So both these players not really in the best spot for the hurry up garbage. I think that Aitu is going to be in the better position, but that miss drop manages to give Yui Metal a little bit of breathing room. A T-spin single followed by Tetris. That's so much garbage sent to Aitu. And Aitu, once again, in an awkward situation where he needed some specific pieces in order to get out of the mess. So Yui Metal, oh my goodness, Yui Metal has two more games until he takes this series to, until he takes I2K to second series. Oh my goodness. There's so much pressure on both of these players right now. Because the thing about, you know, Tetris Tournament Online is that usually only the winner is the one who goes down in the history books. So fighting for fame and fortune. Yui Metal crushing under the pressure. Aitu manages to close this gap to just a one game difference between them. Sorry, it's a two game difference between them. So once again, at this rate, Yui Metal will be taking Aitu to a second series. But let's see if Aitu can turn the tables on Yui Metal. So Aitu is a player that's very well known in both Japanese and the English-speaking community. And Yui Metal, while I have seen him before, I don't think I know too much about him. But I2K, I would have to say that he is the favorite going into this tournament. And Yui Metal is, you know, climbing up from the lower bracket, trying to find his way into the Tetris history books. Yui Metal is in the leader now, but let's see if he can actually keep up his momentum to close out this series with a win. Aitu with a few misdrops here. Oh my goodness. That misdrop is going to be fatal. I don't think that Aitu can get out of this one. Yui Metal is at game point. So one more win and Yui Metal will be taking Aitu to a second series. So, you know, a lot of people in chat are really hoping that Yui Metal will win. Even if they want Aitu to win, they are really looking forward to just more Tetris action between these two high-level players. Perfect clear setup by Yui Metal. He doesn't manage to get it, so he just stacks up for it, a Tetris. Yui Metal Let's see if he can be calm enough to close out this game. Aitu must be under the pressure as well, just because he knows that, you know, taking it to a second series isn't really in his best interest. He really, really just wants to turn the tables here and beat Yui Metal without having to fuss with another series. Okay, Yui Metal with some pretty, pretty bad stack here. I don't think he'll be able to get through this. If he can get through this, he will be a god. But Aitu, once again, he is not going to go down without a fight. So our seasoned veteran, Aitu, is showing why he's so popular in basically all of the Tetris communities. He's really made a name for himself over the years. And, you know, a lot of people know him back from Tetris DS. But Aitu, he hasn't really left. And as we can see, Aitu's still at the top of basically the Tetris world. And if anything, you know, beating Hebo Mai, that just shows that Aitu has maybe gotten even better over the years. Yui Metal trying for a side four wide, but Aitu manages to just have a very, very sharp KO and takes him out there. So Aitu is only one game behind now. And once again, this is the first of 15, but the catch is that these players need to win by two games. So we could get into a situation where both these players, where it goes past 15 and these players are just, you know, just exchanging wins, exchanging losses, and we go to maybe even a longer game than we expected. Yui Metal already topped out. Wow, Yui Metal manages to make his way down. But can he make it all the way down? So he finds the Tetris that he needs. But Yui Metal is still in a lot of trouble. He needs to get all the way down. He can't even... he's just basically focusing on the best way to get down to his garbage. And he manages to get there. Aitu is... Oh, man. Aitu is... Keeping up. But both these players are put in very precarious situations. They managed to make it out of alive. Both these players are now basically at the bottom of their field. But there's so much garbage being sent between these two players. So Aitu with the T-spin double, though Yui Metal intercepts it. He saw it coming. Aitu with that miss drop. I don't think he'll be able to get out of this one. I think Yui Metal will be taking the series. With a flat 100 line sent. GGs from both players. So Yui Metal is going to take it to the final match. Oh my goodness. Okay, so as Yui Metal came from the lower bracket, he will need to beat Aitu twice in order to win this tournament. Okay, so I am waiting to see what exactly we are going to be doing now. I believe that both these players are going to be playing right now. So even going past, yeah, I can hear you. Hey, welcome back,
okay,
user.
Okay, I'm back. Sorry, my internet is so funny.
Yeah, that's okay.
So yeah, we are now back. Both in losers bracket. Right now, and Yui Metal trying to. Are they gonna play right now again? Exactly right now. I don't know.
I think they're going to play right now.
Okay. Yui Metal left the room. Yui Metal left the room. Okay.
Let's wait.
Okay. While we wait, let's check the brackets. Okay. This is the bracket for the winner's bracket that I'm showing it right now on the stream, and we say and we can see that Aitu actually defeated Hebo Mai 15-8 to get to this round.
Okay.
Against Yui Metal, but they checked on the loser bracket. Yui Metal actually played a lot more of rounds on this tournament because he was eliminated on the first round of the, on the second round of the winner's bracket by Aitu, and he defeated Through all the loser brackets, he fixed using Polygon 15-7, then Popboy 15-3 on a really one-sided match, then Squirtle 15-6, then One Punch Man 15-4, and then Hibo Mai 15-7. A lot of one-sided match until this very last round of the tournament.
You know, it's really crazy because players like Hibo Mai, so Hibo Mai is definitely the favorite going into the tournament. But players like One Punch Man, he, you know, a lot of players thought that he would be kind of the dark horse of the tournament, where, you know, he was the one to dethrone Hibo Mai. But now we see Yui Metal. Yui Metal, once again, another Japanese player, but not as well known as Aitsu in the international scene.
They know that they have to play again, right?
Yeah, they have to play again, so...
Because Hibo Mai just wrote Yui Metal won good games. What? No? They have to play again? Oh, okay. I took it 10 minutes. So we'll be right back on 10 minutes. Oh, sorry.
Yeah, but that's quite interesting. Just because, you know, this match will go into kind of an endurance match, right? Where usually, you know... Just think about how many games they played, right? So they played 28 games already, and this is not really the kind of length of time that you usually play Tetris.
No, absolutely not.
And you know, the focus that you need in order to play at, like, you know, over 2.5 pieces per second, it takes an extreme toll on your mental state. So basically, going into the second series, I'm not sure exactly who is going to be favored. You know, if Aitsu is the seasoned veteran, he might be able to take it from a Yui Metal just because of how much experience and the difference in their Tetris history is.
I'm still waiting for this because Yui Metal, it's like the... It's like the chosen one for this tournament. Everybody bet for him on the thread on the forums, I believe.
Really?
Yes, everybody was like, oh, Yui Metal's gonna win this tournament. And that was before the tournament ever started. It was like, oh, TTO4 we will start next week. Who you think we will win? Oh, Yui Metal. Yes, Yui Metal, Yui Metal. Yes, Yui Metal. Yui Metal is really strong. Yui Metal will win. Yui Metal, Yui Metal. So everybody was like losing their minds when actually Yui Metal lose versus H2K on the winner's bracket. Nobody was expecting that, really. At least on this side of the planet. I don't know if Japanese players know this player better than us, of course.
Uh-huh.
But here everybody was expecting to Yui Metal to get to the grand final from winner's bracket.
So the thing is, Yui Metal, so did even, you know, did even English-speaking players vote for Yui Metal as well, or was it mainly Japanese players?
Okay, the room is closed right now, so...
Yeah,
so we have to wait.
Wow, okay. So, yeah, wow, Yui Metal, pretty insane. Yeah, the thing is that Yui Metal, I'm quite surprised kind of by his Tetris style. You know, for the most part, he plays just a very consistent, very lean style where, you know, he just tries to make, like, the most efficient plays possible where he doesn't try to go for anything too fancy. But every once in a while, when we see, like, some misdrop somewhere, he manages to, like, squeeze in, like, crazy T-spin triples, and he's shown as much of his spin knowledge and his Tetris prowess by just the creative ways that he deals with, you know, sending T-spin doubles or with trying to go for, like, combo setup in the middle of the match against a player like Aitsu.
I don't know. Hey, sorry, I'm back. I was editing something.
It's okay. Yeah, so... Wow, so what do you think? So do you think that Aizu can manage to take this series? Or do you think Yui Metal, the crowd favorite, is going to be able to take it? Like,
I believe that now that this happened, Yui Metal has more chance to get to win this tournament. Just because the loser bracket always has like the morale boost that I was losing and now I'm winning. And that moral boost is so strong. It's so strong. It happens on every single like tournament, like the Evo. On the Evo, exactly. Always wins the loser bracket player. and I believe that this can happen right now again, because actually I2K, remember, I2K defeated Yui Metal on the second round of the winner's bracket. Yui Metal got to the grand final through the loser bracket, and now Yui Metal just got the first series of the grand final, and I2K is not right now like, oh my god, I defeated Yui Metal and now he defeated me, when I have to win. I have to win right now, and he defeated me. That's why he asked so for 10 annoying, minutes.
Right? He's like so on a show. Annoying. Because the thing is, from Aizu's perspective, is like, okay, you know, I already beat this guy, but why is he coming back from the dead to torment me once again?
Exactly. It would be different if the loser bracket was like, I don't know, One Punch Man or another player that Aizu didn't play. Exactly. Aizu didn't play on the winner bracket, for example, One Punch Man. So if One Punch Man will get to the grand final, it was, oh, okay, I will defeat this guy. But now it's like, whoa, you are back from the dead.
I mean, but that's one of the most exciting things about Tetris thing. Because the thing about Tetris is that even though there's like some randomness in maybe how the pieces come out, you know, so how the pieces are generated, which pieces you get. But overall, pretty much the better player almost always wins just because it's such a high skill game. But when you put two of the best players in the world, or basically the two best players in the world, against each other, and you know, and both their skill levels are pretty similar, you just get this crazy exchange of just high focus and, you know, just like crazy swings back and forth. Like, we saw so many spikes from both players where you would think that maybe the games wouldn't be ended by spikes. Maybe the games would just be ended by, like, you know, like every single game going to hurry up garbage.
A lot of games are going right now to the hurry up. Since the start of the playoffs, a lot of games are going every single round to hurry up. Every single round, every single time. Unless a huge spike before or a huge mid drop.
Yeah. Yeah, but both these players are so good too at watching their opponent's screen. And they're really good at capitalizing on those mid drops. You know, because oftentimes when you miss drop, what do you think? You think right to yourself like, oh my god, I hope my opponent does not like send me garbage right now, because I'm in trouble. But if you can capitalize on that, oftentimes you can take basically free wins.
On this high level of gameplay, both players look every single piece of the other screen, because they can smell the miss drop. It's like, a miss drop must attack now. They have all the garbage already created, and they just begin like down stack so fast, or just randomly create a T-spin double. Because it's like, I made a miss drop. Don't worry, T-spin double. Okay. So that the APM is so high at this level of gameplay that every single piece that you miss drop, it can cost you the game. It can cost you a spike.
Yeah, you know, I think that overall he lost that series just basically to the miss drops he made. Because I think he lost maybe like four games to just basically miss drops, where he wasn't able to recover afterwards.
I can't believe that he was not on this final. Yeah, I'm still on shock. It's so weird. It's like a TTO final where Actually, Hibomai is not here. He lost on the last round and he's on third place. And you, wait, what?
Because the thing is that to begin with, you know, people were making jokes where it's like, okay, why don't we just call it like Hibomai tournament? You know what I mean? Because Hibomai is going to be in the finals every single time. Like, why even make Hibomai play through the tournament? Like, would just have him there as a final boss. You know, he's the Bowser. We're going to crawl through the castle, you know, to save Princess Peach, which is basically the Asus laptop, the grand prize of this tournament, you know. But but Yui Metal and I2K, both these players beat Hibomai in the tournament. And I think it was actually a huge upset. But as you said before, maybe a lot of people were expecting this. And maybe this is no longer the era of Hibomai where people voted for Yui Metal as the favorite to win this tournament.
Okay, right now, just right before the next round starts and they create the room, I want to tell something. The main idea of this tournament being streamed by me and me starting to create this stream was not my main idea. It was a friend idea.
Okay.
His nickname was Tina Mela, and he was like one of my best friends on the internet, and he just passed away the last week.
Oh.
So
okay.
I wanna ask just for a minute of silence, please. Because this grand final is for you, my friend. That if you okay. If you're watching, whenever you are right now. So 1 minute, please. Thank you so much.
I'm sorry for your loss, but I hope he's, you know, playing tennis.
Oh. So we are back, I think. Yeah, they are in the room right now, so let's get into the room, shall we? Okay, we are in the room. I'm gonna send it to link to you right now.
Okay. Yeah, you know what? I'm also in shock. Basically, a lot of times I'm just left speechless in the middle of the game, just realizing once again that Hibomai isn't in the finals, right? It's so weird. Like, there's definitely something wrong, you know. I think I need to go check the brackets once again just to make sure that, you know, that there wasn't any mistake.
So, yes. They are ready. Okay, I'm gonna try it. I'm ready.
Yeah, make sure you have their sides right as well. I'm not sure if they switched the sides.
I don't know if they're gonna switch the sides, but it's okay.
Okay, yeah, we'll figure it out. Okay, both these players seem to be in pretty high spirits. But I2, definitely the pressure is on I2. I think Yui Metal is going to have it just a little bit easier. As you said, he made it.
Oh, they say good luck, have fun. And we begin the last set of TTO4. Begins right now, when actually I2K gets spike away against Yui Metal. Yui Metal gets another Tetris. Back-to-back Tetris and back-to-back spin door for Yui Metal. I2K with a huge miss drop! He needs to clean that and he's not being able to do it at... Oh, and that's a first point! The first round of the grand final second set for Yui Metal!
Yes,
Yui Metal can make it!
Yeah, so I2 managed to squeeze in a T-spin triple there while down stacking. Which I think is very commendable, but then UE Metal just sent that garbage straight back and topped out Aizu.
Oh, mirror setup for both players right now. UE Metal getting the garbage at the same time that Aizu K. Almost mirror garbage. UE Metal sending a Tetris right now, and he's gonna clean everything up. Aizu K needs... He's stacking. He's up stacking right now. He's gonna send a back-to-back. There is back-to-back Tetris. And after that, a T-spin double UE Metal. There's in the spike. T-spin... No. Tetris for UE Metal is gonna clean that. And he's back into the game. He got the IPs, of course. UE Aizu K is sending, ready to send a fast back-to-back Tetris. UE Metal, oh, some weird garbage right now for UE Metal. He needs to clean that. Okay, he got it. Nice Tetris for UE Metal. Aizu K with another Tetris. Aizu K with another Tetris. Oh, UE Metal got a T-spin single. And Aizu K, he's stacking so fast. He's going for just fast Tetrises. It's like, okay, I can win him on the speed battle. I'm gonna just send fast Tetrises. But it would cost him... Oh, nice save by that. That's okay. Gonna send a back-to-back T-spin double. Two spin doubles actually for Aizu K. UE Metal with a triple is gonna clean that. Is he still alive?
Yeah. It's so Kind of awkward stacking for Aizu, but he manages to... pull it through. Both these players are just not really doing too much. No, right now, right? Like
they're like
one attack.
They're in the matrix fighting right now. They're like boom, 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 boom.
UE Metal with a really big attack. Yeah, UE Metal with a really, really big attack coming up. Looks like T-spin double into a Tetris into okay. What it looks like it was going to be a small combo, but he decides instead to cancel out the garbage Aizu sending him. So we have about 10 seconds left until hurry up garbage.
Oh, this is it. UE Metal is gonna send a Tetris, and Aizu K is gonna send a Tetris too. Let's see who gets on the best and the better position for the hurry up. And there it is, fifth flight of the hurry up. Aizu K with a T-spin double is gonna send a back-to-back T-spin double. UE Metal needs to clean that. UE Metal got a square, and he's another T-spin double for UE Metal. Triple for UE Metal needs to clean. Needs to downstack. Aizu K gets the spike. He's gonna send the spike. Maybe yes.
Just look how fast Aizu is playing.
No, he's not getting the spike. Aizu K needs to send it right now. There is back to back T-spin down for Aizu.
That should be able to do
it. Oh, there it is.
Wow, so Aizu has 205 lines over UE Metal 122 lines. So the scores are even now, one apiece in this grand finals.
Second set.
Yeah, the second set. The grand finals of TT04. And
what
once
a
again,
game.
Same matchup.
Same matchup.
Same opening.
Yeah. They're both playing like reading each other's mind right now. Aizu K with a 2 wide plus a T-spin double is gonna send a back to back. No, he's not gonna send a T-spin double right now. He's just cleaning that up. Oh, nice, nice spin by Aizu K. Is gonna be safe right now? UE Metal with. Oh no, it was not a good position in my UE Metal. He's gonna send just a triple. He's not doing nothing fancy right now. Aizu K gonna send again another fast back-to-back Tetris. There it is. No, it's not. But UE Metal is gonna send a Tetris, a T-spin double, and Aizu K with another T-spin double. UE Metal with a back-to-back Tetris. I think it was back-to-back. Triple.
UE Metal with some ugly garbage here.
Oh man, Aizu K needs to stack right now. This is the chance he can kill UE Metal. Unless UE Metal is not, it's okay again.
Aizu has some really nice attack coming up here. That's a ton of garbage, but UE Metal cancels out quite a lot of that already.
So Aizu K is playing so fast, sending a lot of garbage. UE Metal is surviving everything. Aizu K is like, I don't know, it's like he's playing culture or something. He's like playing a little Tetris style. He's going for full Tetrises and full combos right now. UE Metal is surviving. UE Metal got a main drop. He's not gonna send anything. Oh, he misses the T-spin double. UE Metal also. Aizu K with
so
a T-spin double
attack.
And back to back Tetris. Oh man, it's gonna be a huge spike. Not gonna kill. UE Metal still alive.
No.
20 seconds before the hurry up garbage. Aizu K is gonna send a nice setup, T-spin double, back-to-back T-spin double actually, and another back-to-back T-spin double.
Mm-hmm.
UE Metal is now sending... He's gonna send a Tetris. There it is. Oh, he misses the back-to-back T-spin double, another back-to-back he's gonna that he's missing
hurry
it.
Up garbage coming.
Hurry up garbage. I took a gonna send a
so
Tetris.
What is Yui Metal?
Oh,
doing?
Yui Metal. Oh, he got a floating T spin double. So he's okay.
So Aitu's deck looks really, really good right now.
Aitu, this is gonna be a chance.
Squeezing in T spins. Yui Metal, can he make it through?
He's dead.
I don't think
he
can.
He's dead. Yui Metal is dead.
Yui Metal really make it through?
No,
there's no way.
No, no way.
Wow, it seems like both these players are playing way faster than they were even in the last series. Like, what happened to them in that 10-minute break?
And there is another point for Yui Metal, no, for I2K, and that's 2-1. I2K getting again the lead on this series.
For the first time, actually.
For the first time. Wait, yeah, it is. For the first time. Yes,
yeah.
For the first time. Let's see if he actually this is like the boost that I2K needs for this round, because he's not okay. Now I'm winning. I'm back, because he remember he asked it for 10 minutes. So maybe on that yep. on that 10 minutes he was like, okay, what I'm doing wrong? Okay, what can I fix right now? I have 10 minutes. What do I have to do to defeat Yui Metal? What I learned for him from this defeat? And apparently, it worked.
Yeah, so it's so strange because it seems like Aitu is, you know, the player who seems to be stacking better and seems to be like making more, you know, like more T spins overall, I think. And Yui Metal stacking is like kind of strange, you know, like he doesn't really stack flat most of the time, but Yui Metal really, really giving Aitu a run for his money, so. I'm not sure exactly what Yui Metal is doing to, you know, to have so much success, but whatever he's doing, I think that he just needs to keep at that and, you know, just maybe do more of what he did in the first round, first series.
Maybe he's not playing exactly like the first. No, I think Yui Metal is playing the same like than the first round, but I2K, no. I2K is like...
He's playing different.
Yeah, he's playing a lot faster. He's going for another style. He's going for a fast combo Tetris only style. For example,
Aitu gets a huge spike.
Whoa, man, a spike.
Nice. But the thing is, look at Yui Metal's garbage.
Whoa,
Yui Metal,
man.
Even if Yui Metal managed to get that Tetris down, his garbage underneath that, it was basically Swiss cheese, which means that there are like basically holes just everywhere in random places. And yeah, I2K kind of puts Yui Metal into a checkmate there, and he takes 3 consecutive wins in a row, and once again, keeping his first lead of the night strong.
Oh, back to back. Okay, this is gonna be the game. If someone sends
no,
the garbage so fast, there it is. So much clean garbage.
11 seconds. 11 seconds and this game's already over. So both players opened to the perfect clear and neither of them got canceled, but the problem was Aitu stacked too vertical. So he stacked it in a way that he needed too many eyepieces in order to get down. And Yui Metal stacking a little bit flatter, he managed to send it all back.
For me, that was one of the best rounds of the entire tournament. Absolutely. And there's another perfect clip by I2K. Yui Metal is gonna send it back to back. No, at least
in
double.
What is going on?
Man, that round was so fast, and I2K won. No, and Yui Metal won because I2K actually committed a misdrop, and it was not like a misdrop, but his stack was so vertical, and he. And he died because of that, because both players got a lot of garbage, and I2K was gonna send the better spike right there, but Yui Metal just defeated it before. Now both players again with a lot of garbage, and when they get both players a lot of garbage and a lot of clean garbage, especially by a lot of perfect clears on these rounds, the fastest player wins, and I2K is the fastest player.
Yeah, so it seems like both these players are like, they're almost suicidal, right? Like, they're opening, like, you know, like, the way they're opening, like, they want to try to kind of, you know, find some cheesy free win early on in the game. And, yeah, and as you said before, you know, things are really different this game. Aitu, look at how fast he's playing. Like, he's not misdropping as much. He's playing, you know, probably like half a piece faster at least than his than the first series. And Yui Metal seems to be, you know, kind of calling his challenge. And Yui Metal is keeping up with Aizu, and Aizu's pushed to the top. He needs an eyepiece to get down. He manages to get down.
Oh, man, maybe
not. To make a T-spin double, but it's not going to be good enough. Yui Metal is going to end Aizu's win streak here, his three-game win streak.
Both players, both players activated their bankais and their stance and everything. They both players play with everything.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, maybe both players have actually inherited the Wheel of Fire Bankai from Blink. And they're carrying on to...
Yui Metal got the first perfect clear. Oh, Aizuka is going on so much trouble right now. Nice spin by Aizuka.
Really nice clean up there.
Oh, nice clean. Oh, man, another miss drop. Okay, this was not a nice spin, but there it is. Nice T spin, and Aizuka is back into the game. And Yui Metal no commit some miss drop.
Yui Metal, really, really bad miss drop there. He is going to need quite a lot to get
and
down
it's
here.
It's an eyepiece. There it is. Aizuka, what was but that?
The thing is that when one of these players makes a miss drop, it seems like the other just makes a miss drop right away too, and they can't capitalize.
Aizuka is a really good architect.
Yeah, he's yeah,
absolutely.
He's building like a wonder of the world thing.
He's drawing the Mona Lisa on Tetris.
Yeah, he's basically the Japanese Picasso, you know. just sculpting insane.
And he fixed it. Aizuka was in so much trouble. Yui Metal got the right spike, but Aizuka survived that.
Both these players, they haven't been able to do too much in this game, but both these players are really frantic. Look at that. Double T-spin, double setup there by Aizuka. Yeah, triple T-spin, double setup.
Nice combo.
And he manages a down stack. That should be able to put... Yui Metal all this game. Yui Metal managed to hang on, but he has a lot of dirty garbage coming up here. Yeah, so he is managing to clear through this quite well. Hurry up garbage coming in just about 15 seconds now. And Aizu seems to be in the commanding position here. Yui Metal manages to make it down to the bottom, and it seems like they flipped matrices where now the messy side is Aizu's. So hurry up garbage coming up. Aizu gets a small miss drop, but a series of spins managed to fix it.
Oh man, Aizuka is really high right now. He needs to clean that. He needs a got the right piece. He's gonna say that at this spin double. He got it.
Oh my god, he makes it. In a combo, that should be able to.
Yui Metal! Oh, Yui Metal survived.
Yui Metal hangs on. Wow, Yui Metal, that was actually amazing. Aizu the T-spin triple, but he leaves his overhang. Was it worth it?
He got the spin.
I don't think it was worth it though.
Oh my god, he didn't say no, man.
The thing is that Aizu did the T-spin triple, but the overhang that the T-spin triple left over, it took Aizu a lot of time to clean that up. And you know what? I don't think it was actually worth it at that point. But the thing is that in these situations, I still agree with Aizu. Aizu's play just because. You don't have the time to think about it, you know. You just need to go whatever comes up, you just take it because you know, just kind of waiting on it will make things even worse.
Yui Metal back into the lead. 4-3. This is back again to the lead. It's okay, needs to avoid this. If Yui Metal gets with some rounds right now, oh he's not gonna get it. There it is.
Oh my
another
goodness,
round.
So
tie game.
So if Aizu was the Japanese Leonardo da Vinci, then I think Yui Metal that game was like the Japanese Pablo Picasso. You know, he was creating some sort of architect, or some sort of masterpiece there on the left side of his matrix.
Yeah, see how what player begin right now. Okay, different setup. Yui Metal.
Oh
with
my
a...
god! Look at how fast Yui Metal stacked that.
Oh,
how
man.
Is that even possible?
There it is, this spin double, back-to-back, this spin triple, Aizu is gonna send a Tetris.
A small four wide.
It's another Tetris. This spin double, this was a back-to-back, this spin double, I say a back, another back-to-back, this spin double, hey, back-to-back game by Aizu is gonna pay off. There it is, another point for Aizu back into the lead, 5-4.
So the thing is, Yui Metal, he opened with a double triple cannon opening so fast. I've actually never seen anyone make that setup so fast. But the thing is that even though he sent so many lines over Aitsu, Yui Metal followed up with a missed drop, and Aitsu managed to just top Yui Metal out quite easily that game.
And again, nice pin by Aitsuke. Yui Metal got, he's going now, right now for a fast Tetris and back-to-back T-spin double. Aitsuke is gonna deflect everything. There it is. Aitsuke is back into the game. He's gonna send a T-spin double and a back-to-back Tetris. There it is, another for Aitsuke. Yui Metal is gonna receive the spike. Maybe not, maybe yes, Yui Metal. Okay, he's back and clean.
He creates a double triple setup as well, basically saying, you know, to Yui Metal, you know what, I can do that too. And Aitsu making, you know, being a little bit fancy here in the final moments of the finals of Tetris Tournament Online 4.
Okay, Yui Metal, he got a T-spin double, and a triple is not gonna send a back-to-back right there. So sad, Aitsuke gonna send a T-spin double also. Down-stacking, both really players nice down-stacking, and Aitsuke is back again, T-spin double for Aitsuke. Yui Metal, sending for his partner a Tetris, and it's not back-to-back, Tetris, but that was actually a back-to-back T-spin double, I believe.
Aitsuke, he's in a really nice position.
Tetris, he's very clean right now. 34 seconds until hurry up. Aitsuke got some nice and clean garbage. Yui Metal, he need to stack right now. But he's also very clean. Yeah. Back-to-back Tetris for Yui Metal with a T-spin double. Aitsuke is gonna send another back-to-back Tetris. Yeah, it's Tetris. Back-to-back Tetris. Yui Metal, T-spin double, and back-to-back Tetris for Yui Metal. Last 10 seconds of this round before the hurry up. T-spin double again for Aitsuke, and it's gonna send another T-spin double. Oh no, he canceled it.
I think Aitsu is even getting faster than before.
There it is, T-spin double for Aitsu. Yui Metal, there it is. Yui Metal is gonna, he needs to clean that. We are on the hurry up garbage. He's a danger position for Yui Metal. Needs to clean that back really fast.
Wow, Aitsu really nice stacking.
Oh, Aitsu can commit a misdrop. This is gonna be the game. This can be the game unless Yui Metal. No, he's not able to kill.
No,
there it is. Yui Metal is gonna kill right now. There it is. Point for Yui Metal.
Oh my goodness. What an intense game. The thing is that sometimes I feel like, you know, Aitsu is just in lead. You know, Aitsu stacking is probably one of the nicest, like one of the cleanest stackers in the game, you know. But then, like, Yui Metal manages to, you know, to like, overcome that good stacking just with pure Hearthstone prowess. Sorry, pure Tetris prowess. I got my games mixed up. Yeah, so Aitsu here with kind of a weak opening. Yui Metal not really being able to capitalize on that.
I took a game with some fast. Okay, ooh, that's gonna cost him some time. Valuable seconds by you. Aitsuke needs to clean. He's gonna get it. There it is. Yui Metal is gonna send a back to back.
Yeah, Aitsu waiting to cancel out that garbage really, really well. Aitsu in a bit of trouble here. He's gonna have to clean up that left side. Looks like he might just ignore it for now. Wow, really nice decision making there from Aitsu. Aitsu waited to cancel that out. But Yui Metal sends way too much garbage over to Aitsu, and he just couldn't deal with it.
6-5, Yui Metal back into the lead. I think Aitsuke got an eyepiece on his, I don't know if it was an eyepiece on his hole or the last piece on the next piece, or the first next piece was an eyepiece. I believe Aitsuke was able to survive that. I'm pretty sure. I think we never know that. But back into the game, Yui Metal sending a T-spin double again, and triple by Aitsuke, Tetris by Aitsuke, the least back to back. Yes, Tetris with a T-spin double.
Wow, so Aitsu is having a lot of, you know, really messy garbage here. Yui Metal Not really. Wow, he gets a perfect clear right there just in the middle of a game, but Aitu manages to combo down to clear out all of that perfect clear garbage that Yuyu Middle sent.
Yuyu is gonna send right now another back-to-back. Oh, nice beam by Yuyu Middle right there.
Aitu in a really good position.
Yeah, he's in a really good position right now. He's gonna send a lot of garbage there. Oh, he almost have T-spin double right there. One more line. Was a back-to-back T-spin single. Was a back-to-back Tetris. And a double back-to-back Tetris and a T-spin single. Was nice attack by I2K. Yuyu Middle is now gonna send a T-spin double. And he's preparing for sending some spike, I believe. No, he's just cleaning right now. I2K is gonna send another. I2K is so heavy at APM. Look at the spike. Yuyu Middle is gonna get everything Yuyu Middle needs. Oh, that's gonna be the game.
Wow, so both these players are exchanging wins and losses. You know, no player has been able to get a win streak.
That's 6-6. Another tie game. Oh, sad for Yuyu Middle on that last round.
So close. Like, oh my goodness. You know, it just goes to show you that maybe it's like tournaments like this really do work. We got the two best players in. You know, basically out of the 158 people who joined the tournament.
G-Metal just missed the 4 wide. No, he didn't miss it. He completed it. I2K,
he
deflected a lot of garbage. I2K is...
Yeah. I mean, 4 wide, it worked, but it wasn't like... Too big, right? Because usually, like, the four wides, like, the crazy ones are, like, you know, when you connect, like, the final combos, just because those ones send so much more garbage than those other ones do.
Oh man, Mizro for I2K.
Yeah, but overall, I2 hasn't been misdropping that much compared to, you know, to previously. I think, I'm not sure what changed, but I2, he's looking way stronger now without those misdrops.
I still think I2K playing more with a more speed style, focused on Tetrises and just safety spins. But like I2K is doing no single fancy T-spin triple or cannons, DD cannons. He's not using that. Even for the openers, Yuyu Middle is using some DD cannons for some rounds on openers, but I2K is not doing it. I2K is playing just with maybe perfect clear, or if he doesn't have the perfect clear, just Tetris. Back-to-back Tetris and some TSP just doubles.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, a misdrop there from Aitu, where otherwise that game would still be going on. But yeah, eyepiece misdrop. Very unfortunate there.
Both players sending 97. 97 lines for both players.
It's going really, really back and forth. You know, one player wins, the other player wins. You know, I guess we have to say that both these players are just very, very close and very close in skill level from what I'm seeing now.
I2K has so much skill for spins. He's getting a lot of a nice old spins right there, like C spin and Z spins. So he's like he's missing a lot less the play field like before. And comparing with the last set. With the last set of 15 rounds, Yuyu Middle he's playing the same, but I think it's not enough right now. For this I2K, it's not enough. But both players right now are playing so close that I mean nobody ever got on these rounds a win streak. They're just 1-1 and 1-1. There it is. Oh no, there's it. First win streak.
Yeah, there we go. The first win streak in a while now. I2, yeah, pretty unfortunate there. He didn't manage to basically clean up his field and, yeah, pretty convincing win there for Yuyu Middle. So perfect clear by both players. Yuyu Middle chooses to cancel it out rather than send it to both players. That's quite interesting decision because in the past, you know, in the first series, we've seen him choose to absorb the garbage and to send it back, but Maybe he thinks that now he wants to play a little bit more defensive than be aggressive. Yeah, and once again, the fatigue should be setting in for both of these players. These guys have been playing like really, really focused Tetris for so long now. I can't believe that they can still play this fast and this well after basically using their, you know, their full focus for this prolonged period of time.
Okay, I2K right now is pretty clean, like no metro for I2K in this round.
Nice cancel there by Yui Metal. iTube, he has a pretty big combo coming up here. iTube is really, really nice, clean garbage. Yui Metal is... He's too scared to take that garbage. And that hesitation right there allows iTube to KO Yui Metal, ending his two-game win streak. Oh my goodness. I feel like I'm getting a heart attack watching these games. It's not very often you get to see the crazy matches like these. Okay. I see you just opening up with some good Tetris and T-spin action.
There is the first meter of the round for I2K. But clean pretty fast. And you made that with a T-spin double is gonna send right now. Tetris, I took up with a door T-spin double. And no, I don't know, he's gonna send more. No, he can't.
Yeah, Ice is so good at keeping his stack clean. Like, his stack is almost always flat no matter what point he is in the game.
Or he's doing some mid-drop, like, some rounds he made a lot of mid-drop, but he's clean really fast. So, it's like, almost make, like, no mid-drop, but sometimes on the early rounds he lost because of a nice pipe by Yui Metal plus the mid-drop from ICK. Oh, man,
That's probably gonna end it there.
That's the mid-drop I was talking about there.
Ooh, yeah. So that's one of those fatal misdrops. You know, oftentimes you have misdrops where, you know, it's not so bad. You can clean up quite easily. But yeah, some of them, like that one, ooh, you can't really clean that up without like stacking maybe like four lines above that misdrop in order to clean it up. Okay, perfect clear opening once again by Aitsu. He manages to get it. Yui Metal canceling some of that garbage instead of taking it. Really interesting approach. I'm not sure if I can tell that either player is actually, you know, any... Like, I can't really tell that if either of them are actually tired from playing so long. It looks like they're still playing just as strong as they were.
I don't think they are tired.
I think they play even stronger, actually.
I2K can be actually mentally tired, but they are really not tired, absolutely not.
Okay, I see. Yeah, so both these players not doing too much right now. Kind of waiting to see who breaks the stalemate. Both players are sticking pretty low, basically just, I don't know, just passing time. Nice T-spin there, Aitsu, facing his misdrop.
There's another T-spin double by Yui Metal and at back-to-back Tetris sending right now. I2K is gonna send another T-spin double. Some easy garbage is gonna clean right now. He must not have problem with maybe yes. Maybe it was spoke too soon.
Yeah, what a crazy attack there from Yui Metal. And Yui Metal also had a T-spin double and I think into a Tetris after that too. So he has so much gas going in.
Last 5 rounds for Yui Metal. Yui Metal on the last stretch from getting.
We'll see.
For taking away the crown.
Who knows, right? Who knows? We've seen comebacks before in CTO.
Yui Metal right now 5 games away. 2K needs to win Three in a row to catch.
Both these players are being much more proactive this round than they were in previous rounds. You know, in the last round, both players are basically just down stack and canceling out each other's garbage and showing a lot of respect to the burst potential of your opponent. But these players are playing a little bit higher in the matrix now. It looks like they're kind of done playing that kind of game of, the kind of game of chess. They're now trying to play something more like Battleship, where they want to basically just sink your opponent.
Now, H2K is going to send another back-to-back Tetris. Nice.
Okay, Yui Metal gets pushed to the top, but I2 doesn't have much gas here to push Yui Metal over the edge. Yui Metal is going to be able to downstack to his Tetris hole. I2 is going to be preparing for
Got some nice garbage to
return to him.
Yui Metal got some nice garbage. Gonna send some combos, and not too much, but enough.
T-spin double there by I2, not doing too much once again. But once again, both these players are waiting just for an opportunity to capitalize on. But, being very low in your matrix is oftentimes kind of it's actually bad just because you don't have much options to attack if your opponent makes something like a misdrop. You don't have much gas to fan the flames. Oh. So about 10 seconds left now, going into hurry up garbage.
Dream Metal, what was that? What was that, Dream Metal? What are you doing, man? Oh, nice spin. He can recover it from this.
Okay, a little bit of misdrop there. I2, Yui Metal's all the way at the top. But his garbage is quite clean. I2 still trying to put on the pressure. I2, the garbage hole on the right there is going to be a really big problem. And I2's garbage is pretty disgusting. He manages to clean it, to downstack through it very, very efficiently. Yui Metal didn't manage to top out I2 there. I2 making T-spin double into a Tetris. But Yui Metal, I think Yui Metal is going to take this one.
Oh, no, man.
So maybe a little bit too aggressive there by I2. Putting himself in a position where he was very aggressive, but then he didn't manage afterwards to downstack. And a lot of times when you're too aggressive and you overextend, your opponent is going to be able to capitalize on that and to take you out. So Yui Metal with a 3-game win streak. Perfect clear there from I2. Yui Metal absorbs all garbage. His stack is a little bit messier now, but I2 is having problems of his own, trying to downstack through that. I2 having to put the Z piece on the left side. Pretty awkward, but he manages to get down. Yui Metal, what happened to Yui Metal's field? I2 should be able to close out this game right now, but Yui Metal makes it down to Tetris Hole. Man, the thing is that these players are so fast that oftentimes there's a situation where, a certain should usually lose in this position. They're so fast that they manage to escape from these near-death experiences. Yui Metal with T-spin double into a pretty big Tetris and small combo. I2 is in a lot of trouble, but he manages to clear out his field completely. Ooh, a bit of misdrop there. A T-spin triple there, I2. He's going to need something like an eyepiece. Okay, he makes an eye spin into the crevice that was left over by the T-spin triple. It's only been a minute and a half in this game so far, and this game has felt so long already. There's been so much action in this game. So Yui Metal not being able to find... Wow! Yui Metal not being able to find the eyepiece in time. So he accidentally holds on to, presses his hold button and switches over to his other piece. And what I think happened there was he actually had an eyepiece coming up, but he didn't know where he wanted to place his piece, and he got topped out. So 3-game win streak now for Yui Metal. Yui Metal has a lot of momentum on this. I2 needs to find a way to break the momentum somehow. Yeah, I can hear you now. Hey, welcome back.
Okay, I'm back. Okay, so you better not play gaining by winning by three points.
Yep.
While we get on to the final stretch of the entire tournament. Metal right now sending gonna send a Tetris and Ice Cube is gonna send a T-spin double and a back to back T-spin double. There it is. We Metal, ooh, but nice spike by A2K on that round. Nice spike, that is 9-11.
Man, such a close series. U Metal pulling ahead once again though. I2 didn't manage to keep his lead for too long in the beginning of this series, and U Metal once again is ahead. I2 is going to be fighting from behind, just like he did in the previous series. Okay, a little bit of mish up there for U Metal. Should be okay though. I2 is once again just putting on some constant pressure. Bit of mishups there for I2. I think that this is going to cause quite a lot of trouble for him.
You met is gonna send right now a T-spin double and a back to back T-spin singly one, I think it was. I2K up stacking right now, pretty safe. Mm. Pretty low right now. The met is gonna send another back again the garbage. There it is, pretty clean garbage. Another safety spin double, nice setup right there with another back to back. I think it was Tetris, it was back to back. G Metal, oh man, that's misdrop. Hopefully, misdrop is gonna win right now really fast. But we see I2K down stacking and getting on a comfort position right now with some really low T-spin doubles and pretty weird misdrop by him. But it's gonna
wow.
Nice T-spin double right there from that misdrop. I think it was a misdrop
No. Oh my gosh. You know, if it wasn't a misdrop, very, very.
It was pretty cool.
Yeah. So I too, you know, I think, you know what? I think that misdrop actually came though. Like the misdrop actually came though by from I2 actually speeding up. I think I2 is getting even faster now. He's really, really focused, just trying to close the lead that Yui Metal has. Hurry up, garbage.
Hurry up, garbage. Oh man, that Dream Metal, that was a misdrop. Another misdrop. This is gonna cost him the game. It's gonna cost him the round. I2
is that gonna is, right now. He cannot fix it.
Oh,
that is a fatal misdrop, yeah. Because the thing is that if you look at that misdrop, right, it's a horizontal eyepiece misdrop. And the thing is that you need to stack your field all the way up to that misdrop in order to clear it out. And that was the highest point on his field. So basically, yeah. Basically,
he was kind of screwed. He was screwed.
Yeah. Yeah, he's totally screwed. Yeah, totally screwed.
Oh, nice mirror, almost mirror setup on the poor Alex for the first pieces. It's been double again for G Metal and I2K gonna send a Tetris. No, he's gonna send some really combos. I2K tried to make the comeback real. On the remember, you're watching the grand final of Tetris Tournament Online Forward Competition. Both Japanese players. I2K. He's in his Bankai to get back into the tournament.
Yeah, look how fast he's playing. Like, you know, I would have expected Ice Age to be slowing down, you know, after playing like at full speed for so long. But no, I think he's actually getting slightly faster at some points in the game.
Oh man, that's so sad for Dream Metal. It was a nice spin double. He gonna miss it. Oh, nice spin.
Ooh, a lot of misdrops in a row.
No, it was a nice. It was a T-spin double.
Yeah, he fixed the T-spin double. Yeah, I see being pushed to the top here, but once he manages to get down, he has quite some nice garbage.
Nice garbage. There is T-spin back to back Tetris and back to back T-spin double, but it's not gonna be enough to send a spike to Dream Metal.
Oh my god, Yui Metal is getting so aggressive now too. Like, You know, all of that garbage I sent at Aitsu was all garbage that was made, or all an attack that was made by Yui Metal. So it wasn't any sort of garbage that he was returning back to Aitsu. It was actually thing like T-spin doubles that he was just making at high speed.
Oh man. And Aitsu can get to the spike. Yeah, that is nice point by Yui Metal. For me, that was a clean point. Nice spike. Yui Metal still winning by 2. That's 12 to 10.
Yeah, the funny thing is that, you know, for Aitsu, the eyepiece was just one piece off. So a lot of times these games are just ended by one piece being just a little bit too late and they can't clear their way down. Double perfect clear exchange. Okay, let's see how this goes. I think these are actually the most exciting parts of this series, right? When both players open up with a perfect... Oh my god, so many misjumps from Aitsu!
Oh man, Aitsuke, please fix that. Thank you.
Oh my god, but Aitsu has such bad garbage around. He uses the T-spin double to clear, to cancel, and he manages to make his way down. That was so masterful of Aitsuke.
Yui Metaru with a T-spin double, and Aitsuke, no, she's just cleaning. There is T-spin double again for Aitsuke. I don't see. Oh, Aitsuke receiving some spike. Yui Metaru is now sending a T-spin double. I think both players are playing both pretty on their comfort zone right now. It wasn't.
One piece off. Yeah, one piece off. So close there. I think the perfect clear would have topped out Aitsu as well.
I was pretty sure back. It was.
No, it was a fake perfect clear.
Oh, there is another miss by Aitsuke. Oh man, he needs to avoid that. He's playing so well, but he needs to avoid that miss drop. It would cost him the
Yui
game.
Yui Metal with all these T-spin doubles, so masterful. 10 seconds left. Aitsu managed to make his way out of that. Wow. I think Yui Metal might be like one of the best T-spinners that I've actually seen. He just T-spins so fast. Hurry up, garbage coming up. Ooh, really nice garbage here for Aitsu. Yui Metal's going to be in trouble if Aitsu manages to send all this back efficiently. Wow, miss shot there for Yui Metal.
Oh, so vertical.
Oh my goodness. That's so frustrating for Yui Metal.
12 to 11, just one game away. Aitsuke getting the comeback. Maybe the comeback is real?
I feel like I can't watch, Dazer. I can't watch. It's so stressful. Both these players are just exchanging games back and forth. Such a close series. Wow, nice T-spins from Aitsu as well. Yui Metal trying to stack up more garbage than he usually.
Oh, nice save by Yui Metal. He's gonna send a Tetris right now. Nice garbage. There is another Tetris. Aitsuke. Gonna send, okay, not gonna send nothing. Oh man, that's miserable. What was that?
Yeah, basically losing all of his momentum here. Yeah, both these players are keeping very, very low. I'm actually quite surprised that they actually don't stack up a little more. I think that both players just really, really respect the burst potential from their opponent, right? Like we saw Yui Metal, we saw Yui Metal being able to just like churn out T-spin doubles, like basically like they're like single line clears at high speeds, even without any help from garbage.
Aitsuke sending it's safe right now. He's still playing for me, at least he's playing pretty safe. Back to back Tetris, there it is, another nice garbage, another Tetris by Aitsuke, another Tetris for Aitsuke. Yui Metal getting the spike, or maybe it will cost you the game. It will Unless he gets another eyepiece. There it is. Oh my god. Down.
So Yui Metal had a very very small misdrop there that Aitu tried to capitalize on, but it didn't work. And Aitu ended up overextending Yui Metal, making it out of there, manages to spike Aitu out of the game. Yui Metal with a 2-win streak. So a bit of a point gap here now.
Games until until the end of the tournament. Two more games for Yui Metal. Unless Aitsuke gets like 3 wins in a row to tie at 14. Aitsuke needs to win 3 wins, 3 games in a row before Yui Metal wins one. Man, I can't believe Yui Metal is actually getting to win this tournament from all the loser bracket again.
Yeah, but it's still too soon. It's still too soon to call it, right? You know, I2K hasn't given up. He hasn't given up for sure. Okay, Yui Metal with a very, very nice. I2 is going to be pain soon. Yui Metal instead chooses to play defensively.
Another Tetris for Yui Metal, and Aitsuke with a T-spin double. He's playing with low height T-spin doubles, sorry, a T-spin single for Aitsuke, and a Tetris, and nice combo for Aitsuke. Yui Metal gonna clean that really fast. There it is. T-spin double, still not back-to-back Tetris right there for him. So sad. Nice T-spin. And Yui Metal with another Tetris.
Aitu getting pushed all the way to the top. Aitu is some pretty messy garbage this time around. Yui Metal kind of feeling like he's in danger himself, so he just chooses to just to kind of downstack through that instead of being aggressive. But 15 seconds until hurry up garbage is going to be coming through. Both these players seem to be
Another Tetris, and maybe this is gonna be the game. Oh no!
Yui Metal manages to combo down all the way. Sends...
Wow! Nice T-spin double. There. No, it was a double. It was a T-spin double with a triple setup.
It was a fake T-spin triple. Yeah,
exactly, a
double. Yeah. So Yui Metal in very, very nice shape. Both these players with really nice garbage. Let's see how they maneuver their way through this final stage.
Aitsuke is gonna send a nice spike, but Yui Metal is gonna set a T-spin double. He needs to get the Tetris. There it is.
Oh.
Nice
entry
by Aitsuke. Oh, Yui Metal got it. Oh!
Oh my
god. Aitsuke,
that's 13-12. Yui Metal is making Aitsu work for every single win. Like, none of these wins are free, you know? So, a 1-win difference between these two players. I won't be surprised to see us go into extra games, right? Because it is win by 2, if I'm not mistaken.
I think we're going to more than 15. unless Yui gets right now the 2 wins in a row, I think we're going to more than 15.
But the thing is, you know, in these final stages, this is when the nerves actually come to play. No, but these players should be pretty nervous no matter how good you are at Tetris.
This is
the finals and you're so close.
Yui is actually, I think, a little bit faster than Aitsuke, or like he's playing a little bit faster and clean. But Aitsuke is playing so pretty right now. Playing so pretty, but he's making some misdrops that actually are costing him some rounds. Because he's playing right now a little better than Yui. Beautiful!
Yui Metal is going to get topped. Oh my goodness, look how much garbage was sent over. Oh my god, I can't believe that Yui Metal actually managed to survive that. That was like a full-on combo with, I think, with a T-spin thrown in there.
Oh, Yui Metal just made a misdrop. He's made a misdrop. Oh, he got the spin. He's safe.
Why is this so intense?
Aitsuke needs the win. He can't lose this round, or Yui Metal will be one round ago from And what
that missed drop. No, that might
no!
be it.
That is that no. That is gonna be it, man.
So we are at match point.
Match
we
point.
Are...
Tournament point. We're on tournament point. First tournament point for Yui Metal after that miss drop. Man, it was so painful to watch. I do need to win two in a row.
So this is the final moment now for Yui Metal. Everything's on the line.
This is it.
Let's see how Aitsu manages to.
It's gonna be do or die time for Aitsuke. Can he make his maybe the most important Tetris game of his career? Absolutely, Aitsuke needs to win two in a row.
So Aitsu actually beat Yui Metal before, and now he's about to lose two series in a row to the same guy that he basically already, you know, that he basically already rode off earlier in the tournament.
Here we go, Yui Metal with that back-to-back Tetris. Aitsuke is getting the spike, he needs to clean that. He's gonna make it, he's making it so fast. There it is, it's been single, nice, clean by Aitsuke. Yui Metal trying to stack right now. Maybe not. Oh, it's okay. Oh, nice. He got the TSP and back-to-back Tetris. Yui Metal right now is sending. Okay, he's gonna clean that. He need to clean. He's now on down stacking. He needs an eyepiece. Maybe not. He didn't get the eyepiece. And TSP double. There is TSP double. Yui Metal still. He got some nice garbage right now. TSP double for Yui Metal. It's okay. He got some nice garbage too. Tetris, another Tetris, on some rain, sending some rain. Yui Metal, he's to survive this.
Aitsu's being so aggressive right now. 30 seconds to hurry up garbage, but it might not even get to that.
25 seconds to hurry up garbage. TSP double again for Yui Metal, very low. TSP double, Aitsuke blocking him with another Tetris. I'm gonna send right now back-to-back Tetris. And it's gonna send another back-to-back Tetris. Yui Metal's playing right now. It's so safe right now. Oh, nice spin by Yui Metal.
Will Aitsu's tournament life end here, or will he take it to another game at least? Hurry up, garbage.
This has to be the end of the tournament. Aitsuke needs to win. There it is. Triple. No, he's what's going to send. Oh, no! I think it was a perfect lead. It wasn't, right? It wasn't.
No, Aitsu is in a very
no, man, that miss drop. That miss drop. He did the spin.
Is that going to be it? He combos down.
He gets the spin. Aitsuke is fine. Aitsuke is fine. Yui Metal's trying so hard
to
KO
right now.
Him.
T-spin double into T-spin
double.
For Yui Metal,
this can be the T-spin double. Oh, man. Aitsuke is still alive. Another T-spin double for Aitsuke. Yui Metal is going to be sent.
Oh, my God.
Yui Metal cannot clean this light. There it is. Another point for Aitsuke still alive.
Aitsu's tournament life does not end here. He refuses to give up. He is going to take this to another game at least. You know, one step at a time. So it is still match point for Yui Metal. One more win, and he will be the winner of Tetris Tournament Online 4.
Aitsuke needs to win this round to make the set going.
Oh man, I'm speechless right now. Like, what are these games? Are these really the games of two players who have played, you know, almost how many games now? So that's like almost 60 games.
Yes, exactly. Approximately 60 games. A2K refused to give
both
up.
These players
T-spin
being
double.
Very aggressive with T-spin doubles, falling with Tetris. Both these players
oh,
have very
no,
nice stats. A small miss drop there from A2K. He cannot afford to miss drop
no,
right
no,
now.
No, no, no.
He
needs
make
to clean
it
that.
This.
He needs an eyepiece. No, no. This is what I need. No, A2K. It's over. Yui Metal. Yui Metal.
Oh my goodness. Congratulations to Yui Metal, the winner of Tetris Tournament Online 4. After this entire time being eliminated by I2K, crawling his way through the loser's bracket, beating One Punch Man, beating Hebo Mai, making it back to I2K, and winning twice versus I2K, he is now the winner of Tetris Tournament Online 4.
It's over.
GGs from both players, and that is going to be it. Dazer, are you still there?
Yes, I'm still here. Can you hear me? No, he can't.
Oh my goodness. Okay, so guys, I think that we have a bit of technical difficulties with Dazer. But, yeah, wow, what an exciting series that was. That's Yui Metal is basically a god. You know, this might be the era of Yui Metal where, you know, in the past, Hebo Mai took Tetris Tournament 1, Tetris Tournament 2, Tetris Tournament 3, and now, after being eliminated by both I2K and Yui Metal stands at the top of the mountain as a king of the Tetris world. Yeah, so just once again, congratulations to Yui Metal. He does win the Asus laptop. We will be getting contact with him very soon. And yeah, once again, thanks to our sponsors as well. So we'd like to thank, first of all, Tetris, you know, the Tetris company, Tetris Friends, and also Blue Planet Software for providing us with all of the prizes. So without your support, basically, we wouldn't be able to continue having these community tournaments. So we hope that you continue to support us in the future. And once again, thank you, everyone, for watching. And Dazer's not here right now, but Dazer has been providing such great work throughout the entire tournament, casting pretty much the majority of it in both English and Spanish. Yeah, so big thanks to Dazer. Spending all this, like, basically so much of his free time to do something really nice for the community. So once again, guys, thank you for sticking with us throughout the entire Tetris Tournament Online 4, and we will see you once again at Tetris Tournament Online 5.
Okay, now we can speak. He wasn't listening to me. Okay, all right. Okay, it was so fun. I'm so happy to. Why there's no music right there? There it is. Some music. I'm so happy to. It has been an honor for me to stream and cast this entire tournament. Thanks so much to everyone who was watching. Amazing final, of course. Congratulations to Yui Metal. I don't think we can get to an interview with him right now because he's Japanese and I don't Japanese. So it's so fun. But thank you to all the Hard Rock community. Thank you to, of course, to Tetris because I like Tetris. I think it's a fun game. Do you think it's a fun game? Yes, I think it's a fun game. It can be pretty hard for sometimes. Too hard. Once again, thank you to everyone from Hard Drop, thank you to Blue Planet Software, thank you to the Tetris Company for giving up the prizes to this tournament, and thank you to all the players, like 150 players I believe, joined the tournament, and actually the Hard Drop thread on the forum of the who's gonna win TTO, the prediction were right, Dream Metal won TTO 4. Amazing job by him, amazing job by I2K, Dream Metal with using the loser bracket buff. The loser bracket buff that a lot of players use, especially on tournaments like EVO, Evolution. I'm like speechless, I don't know what more to say right now. I think Chopin can listen to me right now. Chopin, are you right there? Right there?
Okay. Hey, I'm here. Okay, sorry, I prematurely thought that we finished the stream, you know?
No, okay, yeah.
But what did you say before?
No, the forums. Yui Metal, remember the thread? A lot of players predicted that Yui Metal will win TTO 4, and now it happened.
Okay. Yeah, pretty crazy. So,
amazing tournament, so much to happen. All the Occidental players getting knocked out on the loser bracket, and all the team killer matches of non-Japanese players with Link against Microlis and One Parman and the Atomic Number. All the best players from America, Canada, Europe, all the knock up to the top three full Japanese players. Actually, the top four of three Japanese players and one Occidental player. And now the top three with three Japanese players and the ex-world champion that was defeat. That was defeat 2 times in a row. He was on the winner's final. He lose against Aitsuke. Aitsuke going to the grand final. And then Hiromai again losing against Kimetal. Getting to the third place. Amazing run, of course, by Hiromai. Remember, Hiromai, 3 times world champion, now third place on TTO4. And now this amazing battle between the two best Japanese and worldwide players on this tournament. So I think I have no more things to say. For you, Shobain, something to say before we end?
Yeah, I think one of the coolest things is, you know, once again, the support by Blue Planet Software and also Tetris Friends to help us with these community tournaments. Basically because, you know, in the Tetris world, Tetris Tournament Online is basically the pinnacle of, you know, Tetris skill, you know, where there's so many people who play, you know, so many hours every single day. And this is where you go to test your skills against all the other people who are also, you know, devoting so much time to this game that they love. And it's so cool to see, you know, someone getting dethroned. As much as I love Hebomai, I'm super happy to see someone else win the Tetris Tournament Online. And, you know, moving forward, I kind of want this as kind of an example for other players, you know, who maybe kind of wants to test their skills but haven't really had a chance to. You know, next time we have Tetris Tournament 5, I think that it would be a really great idea to just join and see what happens.
So I think that's all for us. I think yes.
Yeah, so that should be for us. Yeah, once again, thank you so much, Dazer, for everything you've done for the community.
Thank you so much for the stream and for everything, of course.
Yeah. Okay, guys, that's gonna be it for us. Tune in next time.
I'm Happy Dazer. I'm here with Chobain. Thanks so much for watching. Greetings from the hardware community. Keep stacking and peace out. Thanks so much. Bye bye.